Hey everyone, what is up? It is Balloon. Welcome back to my channel. Hi, how are you doing? I did change my eye look. The last one that I did, I felt really ugly. So I ended up just switching it out and doing another one. And I still don't 100% love it. But here we are. I'm going to do the other one now. So we're going to get into a little update about James Charles while I do this. Because there's been another article put out by Insider. It doesn't actually say a lot of new information. It doesn't say a lot of new things that we don't already know, if I'm honest with you. It talks about what it would take for the police to get involved in the whole James Charles case. Really, to me personally, I don't think any of this is going to go to the police. There was one boy on TikTok, I remember, one of the 16-year-olds, I think it was Isaiah. He said that he was going to go to the police. He would be filing a police report. But we haven't actually heard anything about that since. So I am doubtful about whether any of that is going to happen. But in the article, it did say that if anyone does go to the police about James Charles sexting minors, any of his accusers, if they do go to the police, allegedly it can take months and months and months to be dealt with. So it's not going to be a short process if anyone does in fact go to the police about it. You know, I really don't see anything happening to James Charles. It should, of course, because as we all know, he has been on his own YouTube channel and he has admitted to doing this crime. So, for me, you know, it is very, very problematic now. I hope that some of these youngsters that he's allegedly spoken to do have the courage to go to the police and actually have it out with them, you know, file a police report and go through that whole process. I don't know if anyone will, but we can hope. So just as some kind of evidence for you guys here, it says some of the TikTok users who have accused James Charles wrote in their comments on their TikTok post that they were filing police reports or had been contacted by the police, but Insider has not been able to independently verify whether an investigation is active in any jurisdiction. So in the article, they spoke to legal expert Emily D. Baker, who is a commentator, a legal commentator here on YouTube. You guys might know her channel. So Emily D. Baker said that if James Charles were prosecuted over the sexting allegations, the statements he's made online could be used against him in court. So that would mean his YouTube video where he actually admitted to sexting those two guys that he said were underage, but he didn't know. And then later on, he found out that they were underage. And of course, we've still had no official statement from Morphe or from YouTube about this whole mess with James Charles. We've had no official statement from anybody, any of the big brands or corporations who work with James Charles. None, nothing, nada. So I'm kind of just like, well, is this it then? You know? And then we've had the opinion from Emily D. Baker, legal expert in this new Insider article, you know, again, saying that nothing is really going to be done unless these kids go forward, fill out a police report and go the legal route with it. Also in the article, Emily D. Baker did mention that it could be settled out of court, you know, by way of paying the alleged victims off, which is something that I have already said here on my channel before, that I did think that James Charles might well have paid these guys off, paid them into silence. You know, that is quite a common thing that happens in Hollywood. Unfortunately, you know, we do hear a lot of it. I mean, if you look at people like Harvey Weinstein, he got away with his behavior for years and years and years. Do you guys remember there was an incident where Courtney Love tried to warn everybody about Harvey Weinstein? It was on a red carpet. Somebody handed the mic over to Courtney and said, oh, you know, what's a secret that you can tell us about Hollywood or something like that? And Courtney Love turned around and said, oh, if Harvey Weinstein ever asked you to go to a hotel room with him alone, don't. And that was like the moment. I remember that. I do distinctly remember that happening. And I was like, ooh. You know, but then look now, years later, Harvey Weinstein has been convicted. So it's like, these things do take a long time. You know, they're not just overnight things. For Harvey Weinstein to get convicted, it took years. Look at the whole Jeffrey Epstein thing as well. Oh, oh my God. That, for me, that is terrifying, the whole Jeffrey Epstein sex trafficking thing. I'm like, ugh. In other kind of beauty guru news, I went over to the old beauty guru Reddit and I was looking at some of the threads on there, and one that I came across was somebody had asked in a thread, which beauty gurus have you pulled the trigger on and unfollowed or unsubscribed from? And I was really shocked. There were two names that came up over and over and over again. And those names, I was really surprised to find, were Raw Beauty Christie and Jackie Einar. A lot of people said that they were unsubbing from Raw Beauty Christie because of all the baby stuff, all the mummy stuff, and they didn't like that. I totally understand that, because me, myself, I'm not into that. You know, that is not my journey at all. I've never actually really religiously watched Raw Beauty Christie. For me, I don't know, you know, her content's just never really been my kind of thing. So I've never really been into that. And then the other one, Jackie Einar. Now, Jackie, I have watched at points, but sometimes I kind of don't know how to take Jackie, if I'm honest. You know, and that's nothing shady towards Jackie. Just sometimes when she's on Twitter and stuff, I feel like she can be a bit aggressive and all of this. And I don't really know how to take her character. So when it comes to watching her content, I'm a bit like, I'm not really sure. But a lot of people had a lot of negative comments about Jackie Einar in that Reddit thread, and I was really quite surprised. Honestly didn't expect her to be somebody that people were like, oh, we're unsubscribing from. You know, I was expecting to go over there and see your James Charles, your Patrick Starr, which, yes, there were a few. Talking about Jackie Einar, someone over on the Beauty Guru Reddit was kind of trying to defend Jackie, and they said, in defense of Jackie, I think she has a chip on her shoulder because of how racist the industry can be. She is mean to her audience quite frequently, which I don't get, but she often makes these videos talking about her haters and how she's above it all, but she just seems jaded and tired. I would agree with that to some extent. Basically, that whole entire Reddit thread was like a discussion about what is going on with a lot of the top tier beauty gurus right now, and also some other people who maybe aren't considered like the top tier ones. But it was a lot of discussion. It was interesting to read through. So if you're on Reddit, you know, go over and read it. But I just found it really kind of fascinating, because at the moment it does feel like there's a big kind of shift going on with some of the larger beauty gurus. Like, you've got Jaclyn Hill now doing a lot of snack and cooking videos, which, by the way, I actually think are really cute. I watched one of Jaclyn's snack videos and I actually really, really enjoyed it. I actually preferred it to her doing the kind of Amazon haul videos. The cooking video was much better. For me, I felt like her personality came out more and she just actually looked like she was enjoying herself. Whereas with the Amazon hauls, I'm like, oh, she's just trying to sell us stuff, and I'm like, not into it. But, you know, a lot of the big beauty gurus aren't posting very frequently. If you look at someone like Nikita Dragon, when was the last time she did a makeup video? And also, speaking about Nikita Dragon, one thing I want to touch on is her Morphe palette, right? So what made me think of this Nikita Morphe palette, the collaboration, was actually when I was watching Kimora Black. She's someone else that I really like to watch for makeup tutorials and all of that here on YouTube. I actually think her channel is really, really underrated. Love watching it. She uploads like twice a week at the moment, and it is good fun, just a good chat if you enjoy makeup, whether that's beauty makeup, drag makeup. She kind of does a bit of everything, and that is the kind of channel for me personally that I can really get into and enjoy. So I'm going to roll this clip from Kimora Black's video, because she gets into it about TikTokers and their Morphe collaborations. Just to give you a little bit of context here, this is Kimora Black reviewing the Morphe Avani collection. She wasn't being shady at all about Avani or anything like that. There was no nastiness in it. But I want to play this clip because there's something that I want to talk about afterwards.
Well, adorable. Like, I think she's really, really pretty, very youthful, very cute, very like, oh, I don't wear makeup, but I do. Like, you know what I mean? I think she's cunt. Like, I mean, I'm loving her vibe. I mean, she's She's very stunning. Very, very stunning. Avani. Avani, that's her name. Not Avanti, I apologize. Avani. Such a cute girl. So I'm very, very excited to see her intake on makeup. So before we pull this collection out, I do want to say, you know, like, these collaborations that are coming out and these features of these brands are bringing out these TikTokers, I know that is the choice now of who you want to feature and things like that. I just feel like, for me, as a consumer, as someone that loves makeup, if I'm gonna buy a palette from someone, if I'm gonna buy makeup from someone or something, I wanna know that you wear makeup. Like, I'm all about this whole, like, no makeup look. I'm all about it with the freckles and things. Very cute, very youthful, I get that. But I just feel like when you're gonna launch palettes, not, this is not towards Avani or anything at all, I'm just speaking this in general, because I know brands do watch my videos, and I just really, really wanna say this. I think it's like, if I'm gonna buy makeup from you, I wanna see you put on makeup. I wanna see you wear makeup. I wanna see you actually doing the makeup. I don't want you to pull out no makeup artist and doing your face. Like, I feel like that makeup artist should have a palette, not you. You know what I mean? Do you guys get what I'm saying? So sound off in the comments below if y'all agree with me. Like, this is just how I start off my videos, you guys. I really do wanna say that. It's like, a lot of these people, these stars and these million followers and things, yeah, they love makeup, but like, bitch, do you really wear fucking makeup? Because what if you do, why is your palette all crazy and shit? And then you look like you just sprayed on water and you just go outside. Like, I don't trust you enough to buy this palette from you. So that being said, she looks cute, but does she wear makeup? Like, I don't know if she does. Congratulations to Avani for this big collaboration. So we're gonna go ahead and go through the PR right now.
See, now I'm sitting here like, yes, facts. Get it, Kimora. Facts all day long. I love it. Live for it. Kimora, she wasn't really being shady there at all. I'm just being silly with my fan. But what she said about these young girls, these young TikTokers and influencers, whatever, coming out with these crazy colorful palettes, and then they don't even wear the crazy colors that are in the palette. Now, I feel exactly the same way about the Nikita x Morphe collaboration. Because if you open Nikita's Morphe palette, look at it, right? It's got lots of color in it. When do you ever see Nikita Dragon wearing any of these bright colors? Never. She never does. Nikita Dragon gets her makeup done by Makeup by Ariel. You see her every day on Instagram where he's beating her face with a powder. And she comes out with a little bit of black wing liner and like, that's it. There's no makeup look. You know what I mean? I wear more color than Nikita Dragon does. And like, this is her Morphe palette. Full of color. It makes no sense. Really, like, is that Nikita Dragon? I wouldn't say that looks like Nikita Dragon at all. You know, maybe some of these light brown ones at the top, but that's it. Like, that's all she wears. Even with her own collection, like even with this, the birthday collection from Dragon Beauty, which is her own brand. Look at this palette, right? Pink and black. When do you ever see Nikita wearing those colours on her eyes? Never. And this is the thing that gets me about some of these influencer brands and some of these Morphe collaborations and stuff like that. When it's like this, people putting out things that they don't even wear, it is just a massive, massive cash grab. Like, I would much rather buy something from somebody who actually wears the colours that they put in a palette. I'm totally in agreement with what Kimora Black said, to be honest with you. You know, I would much rather, like, if you look at Mitchell's palette, and you've got like a lot of color in here and stuff. I mean, this one is more neutral. The other one on his website is much more bright, colorful. It's got cute pastels in it and stuff. But Mitchell does makeup looks on himself and they're colorful looks and stuff. He's an actual makeup artist. He does his own makeup, you know? So I would much rather support something like that than I would like these Morphe collaborations from TikTokers and stuff who come out with the same kind of looking palette like this but don't ever actually use the colors. Like, it makes no sense. Anyway, rant over. Okay, so I'm back. I have finished my face, finished my eyes, my lips. I used the Breakfast at Tiffany's lipstick, this one. Love this colour. I used the matching pencil as well to do my lips there. For my eyes, I actually used the Made by Mitchell Feet on the Ground palette. I do love this palette. It is really, really pigmented as well. Honestly, it's really cute. I used the little Angelina shimmer all over the lid. I used like this tulip shade and this kind of other dark purple plum. What's that called? A mood as well. I just felt like doing something purpley to go with my hair. So I'm going to put on a little bit of the Supreme Gloss in Glossed in Paradise as well. Just because I want something in the centre there. There we go. Yeah. Ooh. I love the feel of these. Because they're like a lipstick. Oh, there we go. Done. Yeah, I know it's a little bit crazy. Most people don't want to wear this lip colour. But me personally, I love all the crazy colours. I'm like, the crazier the better when it comes to bold lip colours. So guys, let me know what you think about all the drama. The Jackie Aina and Raw Beauty Christie backlash that I saw on Reddit, I was like, T girl, T, because honestly, it kind of shocked me, as I said, to see their names up there. I was like, And I know this is kind of a really trivial, silly thing to talk about, given that we've got like all the R-word allegations going on with Dirty Dom from the Vlog Squad, and I am going to probably get into another video about that. Just really didn't want to do that today after all the talk about James Charles and then the talk about Keemstar, you know, not wanting to cover the Jake Paul allegations and everything like that. Sometimes if I do every video like that, it can become a lot. So I do like to try and break it up with something a little bit lighter sometimes as well. So guys, let me know all your thoughts and opinions down below about what is going on with the James Charles drama. If you think he will eventually get convicted or not. If you think Morphe will speak out as well. I doubt they will, to be honest with you. While nobody is really pressing charges or anything against James Charles. But do let me know all your thoughts on that, and I will see you on the next one. So I'm going to say take care, stay safe, stay well. Love you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Bye guys.